Hey everyone, I'm here to look at some more LEGO sets that have been unveiled for release over the coming some number of months. The Friends sets are going to be released June 1st throughout most of the world. I believe it's not going to be until August in the Americas. I might be off on that, but definitely June 1st. But look at some of the stuff, like this right here, Castle Bed and Breakfast. 100 euros, it's expensive, but look at it. Look at how classy it is. Obviously taking a little bit of, taking a little bit of inspiration from whatever place that Disney took its inspiration for its castles, but it's not trying to go all the way there. It's a little bit more modern, a little bit closer to reality, a little bit less fantasy. This is a place that could really exist. And to me, first impression, this looks so good that people who don't care anything about Friends, I think would be interested in having this, even in like a Lego minifig city. Close up the back or put it up against a wall or, you know, an area where you're not going to see the back particularly well. It presents so nicely. Now in 100 euros is a lot. That's around $100 it would be in the US, typically the way that Lego prices things. But it's got a fair amount of detail in there without making things too cramped. I think this space down here looks a little bit too cramped, but at least here you can have a couple people. We've got actually two beds in the smallest amount of space that I think I've ever seen. Another one up here, the tub you can see is actually brick built with some studs on the side construction there and making it all nice and round and everything. They really thought about the era, I feel like, with the styling of the furniture and the fixtures and everything. They really thought about it. This has some nice consistency to it. It's nice to see the relatively newer large leaf pieces also being used in a context with other types of foliage together, trying to make something that looks kind of realistic or realistic-ish. So overall, this feels like a very, very strong product to me. Personally, here's some of the little individual details in there. Obviously a sticker for that, but yeah, you can see that the design is pretty nice. Simple has to be because they're small, but smart, I think. Yeah, look at that. Look at that. I like what they did with this tree here too. It doesn't look good from around the back because of the continuous, very simple trunk. But because they did that simple trunk, you have easier access to everything else. And, you know, they got the balcony here as well. The roof is so smooth. So few gaps and everything. That's a good one. All right. Much cheaper. 30 euros for the Heart Lake City Cafe. By the way, the other one, let's go ahead and head back here. 1,311 pieces. It's an important thing to see. 1,300 pieces for 100 euros for folks who care about that. 426 pieces. This one, I think I have less pictures for it, but this also looks pretty classy, but I can immediately tell that this is completely open around the back. You've got a one stud deep edge of the roof there. Is it one and a half with the modified plate pieces? But I mean, what I see here looks good. It's a little parking cove for the Vespa. Don't call it a Vespa though. The seats being so low is awkward to me. It almost feels like she's sitting on the ground there. But I think they did that. I think they could have raised all this up a bit. Relative to this, I think this is a bit too low, at least the seats, because, you know, compared to the tables there, yeah, the seats are too low. So I think that was a mistake personally, just a little bit, an easy one. Oh, so I had not looked at the back before. It's two studs depth, not one, excuse me, around the edge of the roof there. But I didn't realize how much was inside of this. It's much larger than I thought. What is that piece? What am I missing? What am I not seeing? What is that? That insert that's inside the bowl. I'm having trouble understanding what I'm looking at. Somebody help me. It's fake. It's an effect, just like the heart here in this. Yeah, that's not, it's showing things sloshing around in there. All right. And I like what they did for the small under table cabinets to here, the cupboards. And okay, this is oven with the orange colored doors. I like that. The coffee machine, lots of macarons, macaron, chacaron. What's here looks good to me. I want to see what's back here. What doesn't look good is just the floor. All right. Moving on to the adventure camp theme. They actually have a whole sub theme for adventure camp. 130 euros for 1,128 pieces for this, which is essentially Ewok Village with mini dolls, right? They call it treehouse, but it's not a treehouse, is it? No. It's a whole series of structures, of tree-rooted structures. And even something off to the side that represents a destination that you can go through. Like you take that, it doesn't have to be connected right up here. You move that farther away in play or display, and now you've got some place to go to. Although it's trying to show kind of the entrance to the entire camp ground, but that could also represent a remote camping site as well. And they've got something to cover you for that. We'll look at it in just a couple minutes. Is this a longer piece? No, I think that's just the longest single flex tube piece that they have. But, you know, obviously a lot of focus on activity here, things to do, which is good. Little beavers here with their teeth. I need to see those closer too. But this looks nice. I like this bit of tree up here. Wish there was more of that. Well, there's a little bit here as well. And then you got the evergreens off to the side. Not the biggest picture here, but this shows you just a little bit more of a realistic view so you can see the shape of it. Oh, the beavers can cut this tree down. That's kind of cool. The swings and stuff, places to climb. A lot of it looks not OSHA safe at all, but that's how these things actually are. But, you know, make pretend. Ooh. These are new prints. Those are good. I need those. The beetle and the glow bugs here. I need those prints. And I need them. I do. I like little prints like that. These are just stickers here, of course. There's a closer look at the beaver. It doesn't look too frenzy. I think it doesn't have mascara. I hope it doesn't have mascara. But that, you know, that could pass as city normal minifig compatible. Here's another one. From the adventure camp theme, water sports. Camp water sports? Just camp water sports, the set. And weird name. 70 euros or 628 pieces. Here's a better look at it. There's your requisite frog in coral. You need to see this around the back. These are probably stickers, right? Lots of stickers on the front of this little. Not ticket booth. What is that? It's a place where you go to rent the rides. But this is a camp. You shouldn't have to pay for additional activities once you're there, right? I'm a little bit confused about that. Because it looks like there's a card reader back there. But I like the little rack that's convenient and well done. Good use of the parts, the bull bar pieces for the rack for the canoes. You can also get a raft, a two-person log-style raft. That's a new piece, at least one. It's new to me. I haven't seen it before. The longer triangular flag piece. You have a larger with the mailbox built into it. The larger tree over here. I need to see this around the back. There we go. Thank you. Cool. A little bit of table tennis. Small bear cub here. Watch out for bears. Yep. Keep that one far away from the camp. Yeah, this is like a store. Huh. Okay. I don't think that's. Is that how camps would work? I guess. Huh? I just didn't quite go with the theme. It's more like a little vacation area. The boat launch works. So you've got a little thing here that you just turn. It's going to be a technic piece that pops the ramp up and launches the canoe out from there. Dark orange color for the cap. That's the BB-8 headpiece. So the cap of the mushroom there. Do a little bit of painting up here. This one's not as interesting to me personally, but apologies for my little bits of confusion along the way. What is this though? I wonder what that's about. I wonder what that does. Is it just is this for holding the raft when it comes by? I'm not sure. This one doesn't look priced right. 45 euros for 437 pieces. This has to be larger than it looks somehow. Yeah, it's just a couple of low cabins. So So you've got beds there, and a little bit of storage in there. Little fox off to the side, a couple of mountain bikes. Interesting. I did not realize that they did a new mountain bike mold to work with friends, but I'm assuming that if you switch out that bar to the traditional style of handlebars, then you could use it with many figs as well. That would be good. Or you can just leave it off and then you can ride a bike with no handlebars. Got the little loot over here, mandolin loot. And yeah, small outhouse, small tree as well. This one just doesn't hit as well, especially for that price. Compared to this, like, this is 15 euros. This makes much, much more sense. With a small trash panda back there and two full-size figures, the shooting bow, so 15 euros for 157 pieces. And yeah, there's a better look at this. Yeah. Is that it? That's all that I have for pictures for this one. My bad. Okay. Sure. Yeah, this just seems fine. You know, it's a cheap set, and seems like it gives you enough value. This is a lot less cheap. 80 euros for 814 pieces, and it looks fantastic to me. I like the water park stuff. You get the transparent colors with the trans bright green. You put the stickers wherever you want or don't. The iridescent blue here in the front, big ol' like acrylic. Probably not acrylic because it would degrade over time in the sun. a sculpture, a polymer-based sculpture, I'm assuming there, not glass, of a jellyfish up there. Got a little bit of Atlantis theme going on with this. The colors are nice. The overall arrangement of stuff is nice. Very small slide back here, but I like the roundness of the tube. A nice long slide, spiral slide. Usually they're much shorter than that. So that adds to the fun. And to make up for the fact that it's so big, they have just a small destination pool down here for where you land at. All right, so this is how that works at the back. You actually have a remote thing to actuate the tube slide over on this side. I love these hamster tunnel type pieces. I need to collect those at some point in the different colors that they've made. A little light and go, no go. Oh, the wading pool has a circular feature to it. So it'll rotate around. It's geared. That's nice. That's very nice. And there's a restroom built into it. This is a really good use of space. Not enough safety railing, but good use of space. And that coral color for the classic fence piece. Nice. Kind of keeping with the water space, the water area theme. 20 euros for this for 213 pieces beach smoothie stand. I can barely see that. I can kind of see it. Maybe this is a little bit deeper than it looks. It's only four studs right there. Dark orange color up here for these. The slide piece, the swing piece introduced. When did they introduce that? Was it last year? A little buggy. Definitely holds two people, of course. Yeah, this is fine. You know, doesn't impress me all that much. But I think the value is okay. Just not great. And this especially just doesn't quite do it for me. Most of it is okay, but I think just the sides. Yeah, just some stuff about that doesn't impress me all that much. 10 euros for this for two figures and a dolphin. And vehicles, you know, water scooters for them to use, and the lifeguard tower. Yes, that works. Yep, value's perfectly fine here. Notice the teal color for these classic support pieces back here as well. Nice to see. And that's probably a print. I don't know if that's new, but I'm pretty sure that's a print. Just like that's a print. Your SPF 50 suntan lotion and coral for the umbrella color up here. I think this might be the dark or reddish orange color for the stand for it. Heart Lake City Preschool is a 4+ set, 239 pieces, 50 euros. Doesn't seem completely outrageous for what it is, you know, because these 4+ sets are always rather expensive for their size. So just relative to the norm, it's expensive, yes, but relative to the norm, nothing new or outrageous to worry about. It's interesting that they only show it in the marketing photos from this side. I wonder what it looks like from the other side, but realistically, most kids are not going to be looking at it from the other side because they're going to be interacting in here. They're going to be getting into these spaces. And for a 4+ set, oh, wow, that's a small thing over there. I'm surprised. A couple small things. Interesting. Huh. But yeah, a couple animals. Another small. Really using some small pieces for this. That is surprising. Like that whole stand back there for the butterfly. Just finer details than you would normally expect for something like this. But overall, I mean, I've seen a lot of school, preschool type things from other manufacturers as well. And this is pretty much par for the course as far as what's covered here. I just feel like they put in more small pieces than I would have expected. And then finally, the smallest 4+ set, at least that I've seen so far, it's 10 euros for 60 pieces, including two animals and a car and some side builds and two figures. That totally works. Easy. That's actually cheap for a 4+ version. This is actually, are you kidding me? Hold on. The more I look at this, the more I think about it. This is actually a lot of stuff for 10 euros. It would be like $11 or $12 US. If it was minifig based and not even 4+ with the extra large pieces and prints, there wouldn't be this much stuff in the set. This is actually an excellent deal. That's great. They're subsidizing this with profits from other bigger sets. That's wonderful. I want to see more of that. Yeah, good stuff. And this is a fun little thing. I like the color schemes of everything. Everything here works for me. Little ears for the car. Nice. Nice touches. Yeah, happy with that. But for us adults, this. Wow. Yeah, lots of good stuff. Friends just continues to go from strength to strength. I didn't love every single thing that I've seen here today, but most of it is at least good. You know, that's not too bad. And they got to keep at it because they just keep doing really, really good stuff. And I hope they'll keep coming up. I'll keep pushing their game forward and raising the bar, bringing in more pieces, more colors, and keeping this one of the most legit themes of all time from Lego. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. Talk to you soon.